All right, Teddy Jenner, good to see your face again. I'm sad that once again, I'm going to see it through a screen for the entry draft, but either way, glad to have you on the team again. Let's jump right into things. We're talking team needs. Let's just go in order, starting with the first overall pick, and that is our expansion team, Panther City Lacrosse Club.
Yeah, and in the first, you know, few months of this team since the expansion draft and free agency, Tracy Klusky and Bob Hamley have done quite a good job of adding some good pieces, some veteran pieces, and even some young pieces that haven't gotten a chance to really show themselves in the National Lacrosse League. But if you were to ask me what they need a guy that can play right now. And that could throw a bit of a wrench in the opening few picks of the draft, because everyone feels that, you know, Jonathan Donville is that number one guy, but he's going back to school. So if Panther City really needs a guy right now and they want to get off to a hot start, you know, that could be maybe an Adam Charlambides, or that could be a Dahogan Nanicoke if he truly is fully renounced. So we don't really know what they're going to do yet, but if you're Bob Hamley and Tracy Klusky, you need to make an impact right away in your first season. And to come into as an expansion team, to say to your fans, oh, we had the first overall pick, but we're not picking a guy, we're picking a guy that's not going to be here till the next season. I don't know how that sits. So I truly do believe they obviously need help all over the floor, but most importantly, I believe they need a guy that can play right away.
What makes this draft unique is that we also have a draft class from the 2020 draft who we haven't seen play yet either. And some of them won't even play this upcoming season because they chose to go back to school. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see what teams, you know, need guys who can make a contribution immediately. An expansion team obviously needs that. But let's look at the second pick, and that's Georgia, who is no stranger to first round picks, as we know. What do you think they do with this one?
Well, they're in a good place because they do have a lot of talent coming in from last year's draft class that will make an impact and be bodies in their roster this year. I truly believe the fact that Randy Stotts is injured and most likely going to be out for the majority of this season, that finding a quality offensive right-hander right now is a big importance for them. You know, they have obviously Lyle and they have Miles and they have some younger guys that can come in and maybe fill some roles, but I don't think they have a really big third impact guy. And if they can find a right-hander that can come in and play right away, maybe it is Dahogan Nanicoke, but I'm not sure if they want to jump and get him that high at number two. That is a place that is really stressful for them. I also believe later on in the draft that they are going to probably try to find a backup goaltender for the future, because we know they've lost a few bodies with expansion and free agency in the last few months. And who knows what Mike Poulin does as he gets a little bit older. And who knows what happens with Kevin Orleman coming down the road, or Lane Ruska down the road. So I really believe, and as I say that, I think that Kevin Orleman's not there anymore. But I believe that they're going to have to, again, fill that void of a goalie for the future. So off the hop, I think they need to address the offensive righty. But then again, as they get further down, maybe it's a goaltender they look for.
And Georgia is known for making trades. You know, it's how they've ended up with so many first round picks over the years. This next team, Buffalo, who picks third overall, they got this pick from their blockbuster trade last year. And it was kind of, I feel like there were so many massive blockbuster trades last summer in free agency that I kind of need to refresh myself. So this was one that they got from Matt Gilray from Rochester. What do you think they do with this third overall pick? Do they try to fill the hole that Matt Gilray will leave when they return to play?
Yeah, that is a definite possibility. And there are some good young defenders in this draft that Buffalo might want their eye on. You know, a lot of people like the high-end offensive guys in this draft, but I don't really know if they go that way because they are so very deep, especially right-handed offense. They may try and find a lefty O guy further down in this draft, but if they can get a guy to replace Matt Gilray and get some young defenders back in that core, I really think that's a good boost for them. And there are some really talented young D guys that will play into Buffalo's success this year. But again, they're another team that is pretty deep, and they might be able to draft a guy now that won't be available for another year or two. So it'll be interesting to see what Steve Dietrich does, because this is a team that is always known for having a big bruising defense. But the fact that JP Keeley is going to be missing and pretty much done from lacrosse for the foreseeable future, maybe finding a left-handed forward might be in Steve Dietrich's plans.
Now, we talk about depth and making moves. Vancouver has the fourth overall pick. Last year, they traded up. Are they a team that needs someone to make a contribution immediately, or can they wait?
No, I do believe they need someone right away. And I think it's down, pretty much going to be down between Thomas Fison and Patrick Schumay, who they go with. Both Western guys. The Warriors staff is very familiar with both guys. They know what they can bring. Bison is a shifty left-handed forward, and Patrick Schumay is a very talented, big, physical defenseman. So, you know, this Vancouver team just lost Matt Beers. But they're bringing in Mitski, they're bringing in Reed Bowering, so they're kind of filling some holes. But I don't think you can pass on a defensive body from your backyard like Patrick Schumay. I think he will be a stalwart for that group, and I think he'd be an excellent piece to the Warriors puzzle because they are getting better out the back end. They got a pretty good nucleus up front. They brought in Marty Dinsdale as well. So this is a group that needs help, and I think the biggest help they need is right now on the back end.
All right, now rounding up our first five picks, we have the San Diego Seals, who it seems like Patrick Merrill has been wheeling and dealing all summer. They just signed NHL MVP Dane Doby. Do they need anything else, or do they need anyone else right now?
Yeah, and I think, you know, with their way their right-handed offense is, I think they probably want to maybe find a little more depth there. They got, you know, some older legs. But there are obviously some good pieces there. Westberg is there. Trey LeClair is there. Jeremy Noble will be there. But if they can maybe find a fourth right-handed O guy, that may be a spot they look. But Patrick Merrill is a D guy. He loves his fast, physical, gritty defenseman. And I think that might be a focus for them as well, because, you know, this is a team that needs to get bigger and more physical on the back end. And I think that might be an area of focus for Patrick Merrill. But if there's a right-handed O guy there available to them at five, I think that might be the guy.
All right. Well, that rounds out our top five picks. Tune in Saturday, August 28th, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern. Teddy, I'll see you there.
Can't wait. Thanks, Devin.